Previously on Legends of Aelos, we rejoin our party on the stairs to the main deck. Asher, hand rested on the hatch, waiting for the sign to breach. A bit of idle banter in preparation later, our group ready their weapons and signal for Asher to fling open the hatch. As he does so, however, the party are immediately greeted by the tumbling body of a pirate, trying desperately to fend off a gnashing Sahuagin, one of the vicious humanoids that Roan and Ace had seen scaling the side of the ship just moments after the crash. Roan quickly dispatches the aquatic creature, and leaving the pirate to tend his wounds for now, the party pours out onto the main deck and joins the ensuing battle. Despite this being the first real combat for some, the motions of others and the heat of the moment itself inspire all to act in as expedient and effective a fashion they can muster. Fortunately, the party has the advantage of surprise. The pirates are currently engaged with the invading Sahuagin. As such, the Sahuagin are preoccupied with the pirate crew. Now, for a group having just met, the party acts in a fairly coordinated fashion, and all display the varying traits, skills, and tools that each member possesses. For the first time, we witness Roan igniting his flame-tongued sword, and quickly, if grievously, rendering one of the pirates unconscious before moving on deeper into the fray. Ace rushes forward to engage a wounded Sahuagin. A quick fight, and a crushing blow to the creature's skull, the Sahuagin crumples to the deck, and Ace slowly walks toward the pirate it was fighting. A restrained barbarian rage radiates from his intimidating form. Briar seizes the moment and the trident of the most recently fallen of merfolk and catapults it towards the pirate stood before Ace. As it connects, she also strikes in time with her vine whip, the simultaneous impacts flinging the pirate into the dark drink to be consumed by the sea life. Karun, seeing the beating that Roan is taking, moves forward and speaks a word into his necklace as a healing light envelops Roan, closing the wounds on his body and restoring his vitality. Asher converges on Roan to assist in the push to the top deck, but a pirate engaged with Balin foolishly elects to strike Asher from behind. A mistake never learned from, as Flatfang shifts to his bestial druidic form and rips the heart from the pirate's chest. The fight progresses with relatively little resistance, as the party reaches the top deck and confronts Captain Kerrigan before Balin puts him in bindings. Karun and Briar, under the guidance of the reinstated Captain Tufwald, harmoniously use their combined shape water spells to wrest the ship free from the spire it is struck upon, and Balin is able to set back on course to the Kelepie Isle. Underway and out of danger, now the group turns to the last affairs of combat, the ejection of Kerrigan Cain and the remains of his crew. Per the codes of the sea, Balin offers a maritime prayer to the soul of the soon-to-be-departed Cain as he sets him, bound neck to toe, off the plank. Karun and Asher then assist in the removal of the remains of the pirates and Sahuagin still strewn about the ship. With the final grisly matters complete, the party now takes the opportunity to recover and rest a bit from their ordeals thus far. Roan was fortunate to happen upon a small diamond when searching Kerrigan Cain, and generously bequeaths the gem to Briar, to which she squeals in delight. Karun strikes up a conversation with Asher, recognizing their shared affinity for herbalism. And sometime later, Ace, just after having finished a conversation with Elena, encounters a familiar face in a stowaway found hidden amongst the chickens, Bolt. Though scrutinizing, Ace does find a genuine disposition in Bolt's demeanor, and extends not only his tutelage, but also a position amongst the crew to him, provided he keeps his vices in check, of course. Eventually, there is landfall, which does not go unnoticed, for on approach to the shore, a Nereminian is spotted standing with an umbrella, who flees at the realization of the current party to man the ship. This brings further fear to Karun, still internally vexed by a dark dream or perhaps a vision from the night prior. The Kelepie Isle reached, the party disembarks, and it's from here we shall continue the story of the Legends of Aelos.